Zuma or Advocate Jiba, what might happen, there were political links into the prosecuting authority that then decided not to prosecute both of them, irrespective of the fact that there were a prima facie case against them. And it's because of that political interference that we have to come in. If the prosecuting authority did their job without fear, favor, or prejudice as they should, there would be no need for us to intervene. So yes, it's about politics, but the politics is not on our side, it's on the side of those that protect people because of their political position or because of their political ties. So as it stands at the moment, we believe we should be able to do, but we can't simply go on our own. We need a person that is directly affected, and General Boysen is such a person. So he would be the complainant, and Advocate Karinyao would be the prosecutor. Because this case is of huge importance for us, we don't want to give Advocate Jiba's side any rope to hang us with. So we are doing what we believe. We don't want them to have any other arguments with regard to what should happen in court. But there will be no hesitance from Advocate Nell to state our case clearly in court. With regard to history, you know, if you have people with integrity fighting against corruption and injustice without fear, favor, or prejudice, you are bound to find that sometime when there is going to be some friction with people that have motives that is not in line with doing their job well and serving equality before the law. But as I've mentioned before, it was not Advocate Snell's decision to prosecute Advocate Jiba in the first place. That was something that AfriForum wanted to do in August 2015, before I even met Advocate Nell. And that was why it started. And I think the court would, what all we want is for the court to look at the facts in this matter and make a firm decision what is right and what is not right.